He got drunk, then jumped behind the wheel of his pickup truck and plowed down four people in a drunken haze. So why isn't Ethan Couch behind bars? Keep in mind, he's just 16, too young to legally drive with any alcohol in his system. And in this case, his blood alcohol measured 0.24, three times the legal limit in Texas. Eric Boyle's wife and daughter were both killed.
We had over 180 years of life taken, future life, not 180 years lived, but 180 years of future life taken. And two of those were my wife and daughter.
Investigators say surveillance tape shows Couch and his friends stealing beer from a Walmart store in June. Then they got drunk at a party. Leaving there, police say Couch gunned his pickup, going nearly 70 miles per hour in a 40. Just about 400 yards down the street, he slammed into Holly and Shelby Boyles, who had stopped to help Brianna Mitchell fix a flat tire. Youth pastor Brian Jennings was driving by and had also stopped to help. All of them were killed. Ethan Couch was charged with four counts of intoxication manslaughter and tried as a juvenile.
In one of the most bizarre defense strategies we've ever heard of, attorneys for Couch blamed the boy's parents for his behavior that night, all because of how they raised him. A psychologist and defense witness testified that the boy suffered from something called affluenza, a lifestyle where wealth brought privilege and there were no consequences for bad behavior. He cited one example where Couch, then 15, was caught in a parked pickup with a naked 14-year-old girl who was passed out. Couch was never punished, according to the psychologist. He also testified that Couch was allowed to start drinking at a very early age, even drive when he was just 13.
Prosecutors fought for a 20-year sentence, but the defense argued Couch needed treatment, not prison. The judge agreed and gave Couch 10 years probation plus time in alcohol rehab, no prison. She told the court she believes Couch can be rehabilitated if he's away from his family and given the right treatment. He'll likely end up at this pricey rehab center in Newport Beach, California. His father has agreed to pay the $500,000 or so that it will cost.
Taking him away from his family and teaching him to be a responsible citizen, that's a consequence.
A consequence for killing four people? Not even close, says this woman, whose daughter, Brianna Mitchell, died in the crash.
He'll be feeling the hand of God. Definitely. He may think he's gotten away with something, but he hasn't gotten away with anything.
Randy Kay, CNN, New York.